There you are.
We've done it. With Vanguard Squadron backed into a corner, Lyndon Javes has made his last mistake. We have confirmation that Lyndon has joined the fray. That's not all. He's leading the same rebel squadron we decimated at Mon Cala. This is a calculated move. Lyndon wants me to do something reckless. He thinks he knows me. But he's wrong. We're not going to take the bait. Titan Squadron will focus on our real target, the Starhawk. Admiral Sloan is counting on us. I wish I could deal with Lyndon personally, but a commander's true weapon is a squadron, not a starfighter. Go. Complete your mission. And if you get Lyndon in your sights, strike him down once and for all. This is it, Titan Squadron. Our moment of victory is at hand. The Temperance has broken off from the Rebel fleet, but no matter. Our focus is the Starhawk. And, thanks to the reinforcements from Admiral Sloan, we now have it surrounded. The Starhawk suffered catastrophic damage from our Baradium assault and has had no opportunity for repairs. If I'm correct, a careful strike to the ship's tractor beam core should turn it into a floating time bomb. Reaching the Starhawk will not be easy. The Rebels managed to call in reinforcements of their own. Anvil Squadron, to be precise. Lyndon Javes is handling Anvil Squadron's tactics personally. Anvil took heavy losses at Mon Cala, but they still have starfighters and a grudge. Destroy them. They're also fielding a Nebulon B frigate. We have a raider on hand to assist you. Once you reach the Starhawk, you must breach its armor to attack the core. Scans indicate there's an undetonated Baradium missile lodged somewhere in the Starhawk's hull. Exploit that. With the hull breached, a single fighter can fly inside the Starhawk to attack its tractor beam core. We have no idea what to expect on the inside. Do what you must to start a core overload, and then escape to the Overseer while there's still time. All our work and sacrifice has led to this, Titan. Do not let Lyndon Javes stop you now.
This is it then. Captain Carroll needs you in a TIE fighter, bomber, or interceptor. Your choice.
Titan Squadron is ready. On your order, Captain.
I've come to expect nothing less. The Starhawk is straight ahead, but you will have to cut through the Republic fleet to reach it. Overseer to Imperial Raider. Help Titan break through the Republic lines.
Yes, ma'am. Moving to position.
Heads up! Incoming fighters! Titan! Destroy those fighters now!
Anvil leader to Titan! You should have wiped us out of Mon Cala!
Thanks for a second chance.
And if you're looking for me, Teresa, I'll just be over here with the rest of Anvil, taking out this Star Destroyer. It's a shame you won't come face me.
Traitor! How dare you talk to us about shame! Titan is my weapon. Poised Focus on that frigate.
Radar here. Moving to support Titan Squadron.
These Republic fools. Trapped, outnumbered, and they refuse to accept it. They'll call us weak, even as the might of our empire sweeps them. Your primary target is the enemy frigate.
Here and ready to go. watch out for gravitational anomalies.
Use your boost thrusters if you need to, but remember, the tight space will make that tricky. Don't forget to give yourself room to decelerate.
Commander, a Titan starfighter just breached the Starhawk's hull. They're inside.
Copy, Endo leader. Teresa, what are you up to?
I'm finishing what I began at Nadiri.
Titan Squadron, with Admiral Sloan's unerring support, we have left Project Starhawk in ruins. Vanguard Squadron is doomed. Imperial ideals have prevailed. Loyalty, duty, discipline. And with our latest champion, we shall ascend to even greater heights. Titan III has been promoted to Flight Baron, with full honors. Well done. Your future with the Empire is bright. I take pride that the death of Lyndon Javes sends a message to all who would betray us. That wherever the enemies of the Empire may arise, Titan will be waiting, no matter the cost. This war is our crucible. We will emerge triumphant and bring this new republic to its knees.